You've heard the controversy. The government is snooping on us, logging our phone calls, watching us with surveillance cameras, even tracking our email.
How much of that is happening here in our own backyard? And is the spying really necessary to protect us? Or is the government looking too closely into your private life?
Investigative reporter Terry Parker looks at both sides of this growing dilemma.
When it comes to tracking down criminals and terrorists, Palm Beach County Sheriff Rick Bradshaw is on the forefront of using every technology available.
Specifically targeted at people that are involved in criminal activity. This is not just something that we throw out a cast net and say we're going to look at everybody and figure out what they're doing.
However, in some places, everybody is in the cast net. You've probably noticed the government cameras in public buildings like the courthouse, even in the elevators. But does the sheriff have cameras in other places you don't know about?
We do, but I can't talk about them.
How about at the airport? Did you know they're scanning your license plate?
Give us the information back on it, and then if somebody comes into the airport that may be on a watch list or something, we're certainly able to do that.
And high-tech government radar is watching you on your boat and at the beach.
We're the only county in the United States that has the coastal radar out here.
And this is the creme de la creme of local surveillance, Palm Beach County's top secret fusion center, one of only 72 in the country, monitoring cameras, using facial recognition software, and eavesdropping on the bad guys. But what about on us?
Do you think government is going too far in looking into people's private lives?
Certain things, yeah, definitely.
One lawmaker who agrees is State Senator Joe Negron.
I think government has gone overboard.
Negron just passed a bill that limits law enforcement's use of drones, unmanned aircraft that have unprecedented ability to spy on people.
What I wanted to stop is the use of drones just for general surveillance, to follow people in their vehicles.
Several police agencies in Florida are already using drones. Not Sheriff Bradshaw. He's against them. He says the sheriff's office helicopters do a better job. They're equipped with infrared people finders.
We have ShotSpotter 2, which tracks gunfire, and we have surveillance cameras in certain locations that are volatile for us.
What about just listening in on people's phone calls, tracking cars with GPS, or getting access to your phone records, private emails, texts, and photos? Bradshaw's detectives do all of that, but only, he says, in criminal cases.
Here in Palm Beach County, the citizens can be rest assured that we do everything by the legal guidelines. Everything is done through the court system. We get the appropriate court orders and the appropriate warrants to do whatever we need to do.
Brad Robinson is a private detective who spent 14 years as an undercover agent with the CIA, a spy collecting data on other spies. But as we learn more about the government tracking ordinary citizens' phone records, more people are worried about increased government spying on us.
For the vast majority of Americans, no file exists at all, I can assure you.
Robinson says the CIA is too busy to review data on millions of everyday Americans. And he says some government snooping is necessary.
I think that's one of the costs of fighting terrorism. You can't have perfect security and absolute privacy. There's got to be a trade-off.
But Senator Negron says the trade-off is too great, and all of this government snooping needs to be reined in.
We don't want the government watching over us when we're doing lawful things with our family and our businesses. We don't want the government looking into areas that most people would agree are private.
And this argument is not likely to die down, but rather to heat up. For example, the ACLU is constantly mounting challenges to all of this surveillance. And no matter where you stand on the dial, rest assured, government is watching. Terry Parker, WPBF 25 News.